Hello students, I am Rajiv Jha and here in this video I come with a new conceptual question which is based on difference between SCC and OCC characteristics. So I hope you will like and enjoy this video. So here you see the question. How does SCC characteristics always in a straight line, not in a curve like OCC, and why it does independent with speed? So there is a two question here. So let me take a first question. So to understand the answer, you should first know why OCC curve is not a straight line or why it is bent. Okay, so how the OCC characteristics, let me see. Okay, this is called the OCC characteristics. So this is the graph between terminal voltage and field current. So here stator winding are open circuit. What is the condition of OCC actually? So stator winding are open circuited. So when the field current increases till 1.25 times of the rated value, rated voltage achieved, then OCC curve is formed. So you see there is a bend after a straight line. Okay, after a straight line there is a bend actually. This is due to the saturation in the iron core. So before saturation, what is the condition? So before saturation, we know very well, I field current is directly proportional to the flux. So if the field current is increases, the flux is also increases. After saturation, flux is almost constant. Although you increases field current or not, the flux is constant actually. Whatever the field current you put on that winding, it doesn't matter. So here we see why it is so. So we will have to study two way. First we will think about what before saturation what happened and after saturation what are the changes occurred. So before saturation we see this is called the before saturation condition. Here AB is the line actually. Okay, AB is the line, and through this AB is the current actually, field current. So here flux only get the reluctance by air gap line. So here we see, you see the, this is the field current actually, which is utilizing to produce air gap flux, air gap MMF. Okay, before saturation this is the condition. Iron MMF is almost negligible. Okay, so after saturation what happened? So after saturation, so we will have to put after saturation. So this is the condition of after saturation. There is a line of CDE. So CD is called the air gap MMF, and DE is called the you can say iron MMF. okay, so after saturation you see CD is the field current required for air gap MMF, and DE is the field current required for iron MMF. So here DE is the extra field current through which flux is not produced. Only this field current compensate iron MMF. So whatever the field current we give, it only compensate the iron MMF. Okay, so here you see, so that's why, because of saturation we will, so we just know a rough idea because of saturation we know this bend is occurred. So why, so now here we see the SCC characteristics actually. This is called the SCC characteristic. So let me you can say tell about something about the SCC characteristic. It is between of armature current and field current, and it is always in a straight line. So that means here due to field current, here you cannot find any saturation. Okay, so our main question, or our you can say the base question, is why does saturation condition not present in SCC characteristics? So the answer is very simple. The answer is due to demagnetizing effect. Okay, So, there's a lots of students who are earlier know about the demagnetizing effect actually. So here we just explain what is demagnetizing effect, okay, with a two very better way, to a very best way actually. The first phasor diagram and the second one is flux lines. So here we see an arrangement for SCC characteristics. Here through DC supply line, this is the DC supply field actually, and that is increases in field winding of alternator, and in other side the stator winding, this is the stator winding. Okay, all windings are in the short circuited, you see here. And this current, actually the current is flowing, this is called the short circuit current. So under short circuit current, under short circuit current ISC or short circuit current flowing through the coil or windings, so it behaves like a purely inductive load. Okay, purely inductive load, why it is so? Because as we know, the winding just like we assume as an inductor. So in case of short circuit, it is just like a inductive load over here. So it is a purely inductive load. That mean we will take that mean the short circuit current is lagging with the EMF by 90 degree. Okay, here you see the you can see the phasor diagram. First one is the main field flux, and EMF is lagging with 90 degree with main field flux. Okay, and here you see this is called the short circuit current, called the short circuit current, and this is 90 degree lag with EMF. So we know that, so here we know armature flux phasor in align with short circuit phasor. So from equation, let me just show you, this is called the armature flux, and it is always in a line with short circuit current, because short circuit current is nothing, it is a just a armature current. So here you see from equation phi r equal to phi f minus ka phi a, that mean resultant flux is reduces here, the value of resultant flux is decreases. So resultant flux is decreases, resultant flux is decreases, that mean it is a purely demagnetizing effect. Okay, so here we can say EMF produces is only for the EMF which is produces here is only for compensating armature reaction drop or demagnetizing effect. So how can we say this actually? So here you see all the explanation. You know very well E equal to V plus IA ZS. So because of short circuit current, V equal to 0. So E equal to IA ZS. And from my previous video, I explained why synchronous impedance or ZS is approximate equal to the synchronous reactance XS. Okay, ZS is approximate equivalent to the XS, and XS synchronous reactance is approximate equal to the XR. This is my previous video. I have explained all these things. In short, I have given you detail. XR have a highest, you can say, the contribution into the synchronous impedance. Actually, this is the 0.81 per unit. 81% contribution is due to the armature reactance. That's why we assume ZS is almost equal to the XAR. Okay, so here you see E equal to IXE into XAR. So that means whatever the EMF produced is only for compensating armature reaction drop or demagnetizing. So this is the second way we will explain the concept of demagnetizing through flux line. So here you see this is the stator and the stator without conductor, and this is the rotor part. In rotor there is no supply, so we are not getting any poles over here. So first we will have to give the supply. So we will give the supply, and here you see the poles. This is called the south pole, north pole, and then south pole. In alternate we will get the poles actually. Then we want to rotate the rotor into the clockwise direction. Okay, so this is the clockwise direction, we will rotate it. Then after we put some conductor that follow the lagging power factor load, because we will discuss earlier, whenever the short circuit occurred, the stator winding side behave like a zero power factor load, or unity, you can say the purely inductive load. Okay, so we will have to put conductor in such a way that it behaves like purely inductive load. So here it is. So this is the lagging actually. This is the pole and this is lagging. So it is a lagging power factor. So now we'll come to the next slide. So you see, so here EMF is produces in the stator winding, and direction of current you will get through Fleming's right hand rule. You know very well about right hand rule, Fleming right hand rules. So here first coil side, it is in the inward side actually, and second coil side, it is outward. Okay, here you see outward side. So through this we can also, so here so now we know in south pole magnetic field lines comes towards the pole, and in north pole magnetic field lines goes from the pole actually. So by applying Fleming right hand thumb rule, thumbs put of current direction, and fingers shows the direction of magnetic field, and it is also called the armature flux actually. So here you see the direction. This is the direction of armature flux, and this is the direction of main field flux. So here the flux is reduces. From here the flux is also reduces, because this is the direction of main field flux, this is the direction of armature flux. Flux is also decreases, reduces. Here the flux is also reduces. You see, you check it once. Here the flux is also reduces. So in this case the flux is total flux is reduces. That mean, so this is called the, that mean this is called the demagnetization or demagnetizing effect, or this is called the reduction of total flux. Okay, so now we have so from this way we can say we explain the demagnetizing effect, and now we know the answer. So the question was, how does SCC characteristics always in a straight line, not in a curve like OCC? So answer is, under short circuit condition IF only supply to demagnetizing armature reaction. Okay, that is the answer actually. So I told you about, there's a two way I explained the demagnetization effect. So from this way we can say that is the IF. So under SCC condition IF only supply the demagnetizing armature reaction, and that's why it can't be saturated. So here our next question, we will have to go further for the next question. The next question is, why it does independent with speed? Okay, so here we see the equation, ISC equal to That means short circuit current equal to EMF upon XS, and here we know XS is almost equal to XAR, armature reactance. Okay, so E is directly proportional to what is the value of E? E is equal to 4.44 F T kW phi. kW is the winding factor and the F is the frequency. So E is directly proportional to frequency, and XS equal to 2 pi F into L. That means XS is also depends on the frequency. So here we see E directly proportional to frequency and XS is directly proportional to frequency. So we can cancel out this. Okay, so we can also say that ISC is independent to the frequency. That means ISC is, there is no relation between the ISC and frequency. And from the equation we also know N equal to 120 F upon P. That means frequency directly depends on speed. So if ISC is independent with frequency, so ISC is also independent with speed. So that is why speed is independent with SSC characteristics. Okay, so that is the way we can try to explain it. But in practical, you see there is a graph which is initially for a small speed. Okay, for a small speed, actually it depends on frequency. Okay, this is because a small speed directly proportional to the frequency. Speed is directly proportional to the frequency. So here excess is, the value of excess is reduces when the speed is small. That means in that case the armature resistance, which neglected in the previous section, is dominated with XAR. So instead of XS we write down is RA. So ISC in this case, then E directly proportional to frequency and RA does not, or you can say that it is not any proportional, or it is independent with frequency. So ISC is directly proportional to the frequency now. So initially, that's why for a small speed, short circuit characteristics depends on frequency, but this is a very small duration, so we can neglect it. So that's why the short circuit characteristics is not depend, or it is independent with the speed. Okay, so initially speed is a very little value, so it can be ignored, and it is true if I say SCC independent with speed. And the next one is, thank you for being with this video. I hope you learned.